Hello everyone, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. I am Chaitanya Munje and in this video we will be building a simple application in which we will be adding a user authentication with Firebase. Along with that, we will be also performing CRUD operations using real-time database in Android. So here is the sample application which I have already built. Inside this, we can firstly get to see a login page, and on clicking on the new user, we can get to see a registration page. So I have already created one user. I will simply login it. Then I will simply login it. So here we can get to see login has been successful, and we can get to see different courses available here. So these courses have been already added in the database, that is Firebase database, and we can get to see it here. Now I will quickly add the one new course. So for that I will simply click on this floating action button, and here I will add new course, and I will add course price. Then after that I will add the course image link which I have already opened up here, that is course image link. Then I will add the course link which is here. Similarly, I will copy this description, that is course description, and will add it. Then I will add this course, so it will be added to our Firebase real-time database. So we can get to see the course here. So this is the course which we just added. So after clicking on this course, we can get to see the course name details. It is suited for beginners and the other details. So as we click on view details, we can get to see this type of a web page open inside our mobile application. So this is our course description. Now we will go back. Now we have seen the login operation and adding the data to the Firebase database. Now we will take a look at the update operation. So this one is the DSA course, so I will edit this course. Inside this I will simply change DSA self, that is price, from 100 to 1000, and then we'll simply update this course. So this course has been updated. Here we can get to see the price is around 1000. Now we will simply delete other course. So here is the Geeks Classes Love. We will edit this course and we will simply delete this course. So we'll go at the bottom and then simply click on delete to delete this course. Now we can get to see this course has been deleted from the list. So this course has been deleted. So now we have seen the login operation, create, adding the new course to our database, updating, deleting, as well as reading operation is performing on the main screen. That is, we are reading all the courses from our database. Now I will simply log out from this application. Now I will register with a new user. So inside this, we have to firstly add the username. Username will be any type of a email. So I will adding as a sample. Then I will specify password. Then confirm password. And then we simply click on register to register our user. So our user has been registered and he will also get to see all the courses which are available. Now I will again log out and log in with the same username. As this user has been already registered, so we can get to see the account of that particular user. So this is what we are going to build in today's video. Now we will quickly move towards our Android Studio. So it is open. Inside Android Studio, we have to simply create a new project, then select empty activity, next. Here we have to specify the application name as Firebase CRUD app application. Make sure to select the language as a Java. Then we have to simply click on finish to create a new project. Now our Android Studio project has been created and we can get to see two files, that is activity underscore main.xml and main activity.java file. Now firstly, we will connect our project to the Firebase database. So for that, we have to simply go to our browser and then we have to go to this site, that is firebase.google.com. Then we simply have to go to our console. Inside our console, we have to simply click on add a new project or add a project option. Then we have to specify our project name. Then click on continue to create our new project. Here we have to again press continue. Here we have to select the default Google Analytics account. Then we have to create our new project. Now our project has been created and we can get to see this type of a screen. So now we have to connect our application. So for that, we have to simply click on Android icon. And here we have to specify the package name of our application. So we will again go to Android Studio. Inside mainactivity.java file, here is our package name. So we will simply copy this and we will paste it here. After that, we will specify the name of our app and then we have to register our application. After registering, we have to download this googleservices.json file. We will open this file inside our folder. We will simply copy this file and paste it inside our Android Studio project which we have created recently. Now inside our project, we have to change it to project. Then inside this, we have to go to the app, then source, main, inside the source we have to paste this file. Here we can get to see the location as well, that is inside the app folder itself we have to paste it. So we will simply paste this file here. Make sure to change the name as googleservices.json without any spacings, otherwise it may provide some issue. So keep the name as it is, that is googleservices.json, and then simply click on OK to add this file. So now we have added this googleservices.json file. Now we will again go to our Android and then we have to add the different dependencies. So for adding this, we have to go to tools. Then inside that we can get to see Firebase section. And here we can get to see different types of services which are provided by Firebase. So we will be using authentication and real-time database. So for authentication, we will be using a simple, that is custom login. Authenticate using a custom system. So inside this, we have to simply add Firebase real-time database SDK. So we have to accept changes. So it will add dependencies for Firebase authentication. Then we have to go to build.gradle and here we can get to see dependencies have been added. It will automatically sync our project. Similarly, we have to add the dependencies for. Now we have to again go to our assistant. So here we have added these dependencies, so we can get to see this check mark. Now again we have to go to this real-time database section and then get started with real-time database. After that we have to simply add the dependency for Firebase database as well, that is real-time database, inside which we will be performing our CRUD operations, that is adding, updating, reading data as well as deleting the data. Now after this, we will be loading the images from URL. So for that we will be using Picasso. Other than Picasso, there are several different sources such as libraries available such as Glide, Fresco and many others. The link for all these articles will be present in the description box below. You can check it out for more information. Now we will add the dependency for Picasso. Now after that we have to add one more dependency of Firebase, so we will be adding that. Here we have to add platform. Now after adding this dependency, we have to simply sync our project once again to install all these dependencies. Now we have installed all our dependencies. Now firstly we will go to our Firebase console once again, and then we simply have to go to the next, and here is all the information regarding adding the dependencies. So we have added it customly, then we have to simply go to the next one and then continue to console. So here we can get to see the name of our application which is added, and here are the different types of services which are provided by Firebase for Android application. So first one is the authentication which we will be using. So inside the authentication we can get to see this type of a screen. Inside simply click on get started. So Firebase provides the different types of authentication services such as by email and password which we will be using. Then comes the phone, Google sign in, Facebook, Twitter and many more providers are there. So we will be using email and password. So currently it is disabled, so we have to enable it. So we will simply click on email and password and then click on enable. And then we have to save, as we will be using this service inside our application. Now once we have added all, we have authenticated any user from our application, we can get to see the list of users present here. So when after creating our project, when we authenticate a new user, we can get to see the user's details here. Now after that there comes a real-time database as well as Firestore database. Firestore and real-time are pretty similar. So we will be using real-time database. Inside this we can firstly get to see a create database option. So we have to simply click on create a database, then we have to select as a United States US general and then next. After clicking on next, we have to simply start in a test mode. As we are testing our application, so we have to specify start in a test mode, whereas for lock mode the read and write permissions will be false, so we will not be able to read as well as write. So currently we are testing our application, so we have to simply click on start in a test mode. The link for this documentation will be present in description box below, or you can simply click on learn more to check out the details about how to use the rules in the Firebase database. Now after clicking on start a test mode, we have to enable the database. Now after creating this, we can get to see this type of screen, and inside this, we after adding all the data, we can get to see the tree type of structure. Now after that, for modifying our rules, we can go to rules tab and then modify our rules. Currently the rules are being set to the test mode, so we will be using that itself. Now we have done working in the Firebase, we have enabled the authentication provider, that is we will be using email and a password, and we have also set up our real-time database. So inside which we will be performing different CRUD operation. Also we can check out the documentation for using the Firebase database from this section, that is go to docs. Now we will quickly go towards our Android Studio project, and inside this we have to create the different activities. So first activity, that is main activity which is already created. So this activity will be for our home screen, inside which we will be displaying all the list of courses which are currently available or currently we have added inside our database. Then we will be creating the next activity, which will be the add new course activity. So we will simply select activity, then empty activity, and here we will specify the name as add course activity. This inside this activity we will be adding a new course. So we have created this add course activity. Then we will create again one more activity which will be for edit course activity, inside which we will be editing as well as deleting our courses which are been already added. So So for that we have to go again to our package name. We have to specify the name as edit course activity, inside which we will be editing our courses which are already added. So our edit course activity also been created. Now next comes is the login activity, inside which user will be performing the login operation. So we will again create an empty activity and we will specify the name as login activity. Then click on finish, and after that we will be creating one more activity which will be for registration. So we will specify the name it for that activity as a registration activity. So registration activity will be used for creating a new user. So these are the different activities which we have created. So the first one is the add course activity, in which we will be adding a new course. Then edit course activity, which will be used for editing a course which has already been added. Then login activity for user login, main activity for displaying the list of all the courses which are available, and then registration activity is to register a new user. Now we have created all our activities, so we will close all these files and then we will move towards the values folder, inside which we will firstly update our colors. So inside colors folder, that is, we have to go to the res values and then colors.xml, and here we will be updating our colors. Then we will be adding the one more color. This will be for material text input layout. This will be stroke color for our text input layout. Now here we have added different colors, then we have to go to the themes folder, inside which we will be adding the custom styling. We will be creating different styles. So the one style will be for our bottom sheet, and then the next we will be creating for our, that is, text input layout edit text. Inside this we have to specify the item name. So the first will be our box stroke color, Then the next will be our box stroke width, which will be around 1 dp. Now after creating this, we have to create a model style, one more style. So these are the style for our bottom sheet. Inside which we will be creating a custom drawable file for our bottom sheet. So we have to go to the drawables, then right click. We will be creating a custom drawable and name it as a round drawable. We will change it to shape. This will be for background of our bottom sheet. Inside this, we will be adding the shape as rectangle. Then we will be adding the radius, that is corners, that is top right radius, around 20 dp. Similarly, we will be adding the one more corner, that is top left radius for our bottom sheet. And then we will be adding it here. Now we have completed the style folder. After that, we have to go to our first activity which we will be creating, that is the registration activity, and we will be closing the others as well. Inside registration activity, we will be firstly working on the XML part. So here we will change the root layout to relative one. Now inside our relative layout, we will firstly specify the background. Blue shade one. Now inside this, we will be creating the three different edit text. So three edit text. The first one will be for our username, then password, and then confirm password. So for that, we will specify text input layout. Then we will specify width as match parent. Height as wrap content, ID as we'll specify margin start as 20 dp. Margin top as 140 dp. We'll specify hint as enter username, style as we have added the style inside themes, so its name is text input layout. Then we will be adding padding as 5 dp, text color hint as white, text color hint text color also as white. Now inside this text input layout, we will be creating a text input edit text. Specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, ID as Then we will add import autofill hints to no. Here we will be adding input type as text email address. Then we will specify text color as white, text color hint also as white, text size as 14 sp. Now we have created our first edit text, which will be our username. So we will simply copy this edit text and use it multiple times. Now, so this one is our first, that is username. Here we will change the ID as TL2 password, and we will align it below to our ID TL username. Here we will change margin top to 20 dp, and we will also change the hint. Enter your password. We'll change ID for this one as well. And here as well, we will change the text input layout to confirm password. We will align this text input layout below our password, and we will update the margin top to 20 dp, and here we will change the input type as password, and in the above section as well, we will change the input type as password. Here it will be text password. Now we have to create a button. Now we will be adding the custom background for our button. So for that, we will be creating a custom background. We will also specify ID as so for creating custom background, we have to go to drawable, right click new, drawable resource file, custom button back. We will change selector to shape. And we will create this. Inside this, we will specify our shape as rectangle. Then we will specify solid color as our blue shade one. After that, we will specify corner radius as 10 dp, or we will increase it a little bit to 20. Now we will add this background to our button. Now we have created our button. We will specify text color as white. Now after this register button, we are also displaying a simple text view in which we are displaying already a user that login. So for that, we will simply create a text view. Specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, text as already a user. Login here. We will specify text color as white, text all caps as false, text alignment as center, gravity also as center. We will align it below to our register. We will add margin top as 30 dp, we will increase the text size little bit. That is, we will specify text size as 18 SP, and we will also specify the ID to this one as well. Now we have created the UI for our, that is, register activity. Along with that, we have to also create a progress bar. So we will be creating a custom progress bar. So for that, we have to create a drawable for progress bars. There is a separate article on how to create a custom progress bar in Android. So the link for that article will be present in the description box below. So we have to go to the drawable, then new drawable resource file, progress back, and here we have to change it to rotate. Inside this, firstly, we will be creating the, that is, pivot x and pivot y and from degree. So we will have to add the animation. For that, firstly we will be adding from degrees to 0, then we have to add pivot x as 50%. Similarly, we have to add pivot y as 50%. Then we have to rotate it to 2 degrees, that is 360. After that, we have to specify the shape. Then in the radius, we will be adding in the radius ratio as 3. Inside this shape, we have to specify the size. Inside this, we have to specify gradient to our progress bar. We will specify the angle as 0. Then end color. Then start color. Now we have created our progress bar, so we will be using this one here. For that, firstly we have to create a progress bar, specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content, then we have to align it center. After that, we have to add the custom drawable to this progress bar. So for that, firstly we have to add indeterminate to true. Then we have to add indeterminate drawable. That is progress back. And we have to set visibility initially as gone. Now we have created all the views for our registration activity. So we will create the variable for it and initialize this, as well as we will be complete the registration activity flow. So firstly, we have to create variable for our text input edit text. So first variable will be username edt, then password edt, confirm password edit text. After that, we will be creating a variable for our button, that is register button, then our progress bar, now we have to again one more create a variable, that is for Firebase auth, and we will specify it as a mauth. Now after that, we have to initialize all our variables which we have created. So firstly, we will be initializing our username edit text. Similarly, we will be initializing all others as well. Now after initializing all our variables, we have to get instance of our Firebase auth. Firebase auth dot get instance. So this will provide the instance of our Firebase auth. Now after that, we also have to create one more variable for our text view, that is the login text view. So we will initialize this as well. After that, firstly we'll be adding onClickListener for our login text view. New view.onClickListener, and inside this we will be opening a login activity. So we will be specifying intent, new intent, then we will be calling registration activity. And we will simply calling start activity as I. After that, we have to add onClickListener for our button, that is register button. Inside this, firstly we will be displaying loading progress bar. Then we will be creating a three strings, that is username, password and confirm password. Username edit text dot get text dot to string. Similarly, we'll be creating the to string as well. Now, after getting all this data from our edit text, we will be validating it. So, firstly, we will be checking if password is not equal to confirm password, then we will simply displaying a toast message as please check both password. Now we will be adding else if condition inside which we will be checking whether the added data is empty or not. TextUtils dot is empty. So firstly we will be passing username, then similarly we will be checking it for password. And then we will be displaying a toast message. At last we will be calling the else inside which we will be creating our new user. So for that we will be simply calling mauth.createUser with email and password, and inside this we have to specify the username and password, that is username and pwd, and then we will have to simply call add on complete listener method. New on complete listener. Inside on complete listener we will firstly, here this one is not required, so we will remove this. We will firstly check if the task is successful. So if the task is successful, we have to change visibility of our loading progress bar as gone. Then we will be displaying a message. Then we will be calling intent. We will be calling our login activity, or we can simply call our main activity as well. Login activity dot class, and after that we have to simply call start activity I, and then we will be calling finish to close this current activity, that is registration activity. And we will be also adding the else condition as well. If the registration is failure, then we will simply display loading progress bar dot set visibility as gone, and we will display a toast message as failed to register user. So we have completed the coding part for our registration activity, but before that we have to add the permission as well inside our manifest file, and we have to change the default activity as well. So inside our manifest file, we will firstly add the user's permission as internet, as we are using internet for reading and updating all the performing all operations. Then we will be adding one more permission, that is access network state. Now after that, here are the different activities that is we are using inside our application. So currently our launcher activity is set to our main activity, but we have to set it to login activity. So we will copy this, and inside this login activity we will add that particular code. So this will be our login activity. Now the login activity is set to be the default. Whenever our app opens for first time, we will get to see login activity rather than our main activity. And inside the login activity, it will check whether the user is already authenticated or not. And if it is authenticated, then we will go towards our main activity. So login activity will be set to a default. Now we will go to our login activity. We have completed the coding part for our registration activity. So this is all the coding. And then this is the XML file. Now we have to go to our, that is login activity, and inside that we have to firstly start working on the activity underscore login.xml. So here also we will change it to relative layout firstly. Then we will specify background. Blue shade one. Now we will, the UI of this one as well as the registration is similar, so we will copy this UI. Only the difference is the confirm password section is not there. So we will be removing that one only. We will be removing this confirmed password text view, and we will be aligning as pass below to our password. We will changing the text to login. ID button login here as well. Here we will changing the message as new user register here. We will be changing the IDs. We can keep this as it is, that is, it is a username and password. We will be increasing the top margin little bit. Now we have created the UI for our activity underscore login.xml. Now we have to initialize all these variables which we have created. So we will go to our login activity, and we will firstly create the variable for our text input edit text. Then for our button, then we will be creating variable for our text view, which is our register TV and Firebase auth as well. Now we have to initialize all our variables. We will call Firebase auth.get instance. Now we will firstly add the on-click listener for our register TV. And inside this we will be opening our intent, that is our register activity. So we will opening that activity. Now as inside the application we have seen that when the user is already logged in, so we are directly opening the home screen. So currently inside the application we can get to see a user is already been logged in. So we will close our application and open our application once again, so we can directly get to see our home screen rather than our login screen. So how we can handle this? So Firebase provides a default method where we can use that method to check whether the user is already been authenticated or not. So we have to only check whether the user is already authenticated. So for that we will be calling the onStart method, that is onStart method, and inside this method we will be checking whether the user is already authenticated. So we will be getting the user firstly. By using mauth.getCurrentUser. So we will be checking if the user is not equal to null, which means if user is already existing. If user is not equal to null, then we have to simply open our home, that is home screen, which is our main activity.java file. So we will be simply calling login activity.this, comma main activity.class, and we will be starting our activity. Inside onStart, we are checking whether the user is already been authenticated or not, and then we are simply sending it to our main activity. Now we have to add onClick listener for our login button. Inside login button, firstly we will be getting the data from our text field. So we will be creating text field string as username. Similarly for password, now here also we will be validating whether the data entered by user is empty or not. Then we are displaying a toast message whether if the username and password is empty. And we are simply returning it. In the else condition, the data is present inside the field. So we will be simply calling mauth.signinwithuser and password, that is sign in with email and password. And here we have to pass the email, that is our username, then password. PWD. Then we have to simply call add-on complete listener. On complete listener. Inside the on complete method, we will check whether the task is successful or not. If the task is successful, then we will firstly change the visibility, that is loading progress bar visibility as gone. And here also we will have to change the loading progress bar visibility as visible. Here we will display a toast message. Now after login we have to open a new screen, that is our main activity. we are simply calling finish, so that when user presses back, he will not be able to go to our login activity once again. And in else condition, we will simply display a toast message, fail to login, and we will change visibility as gone. Now we have completed the coding part for our login activity as well as the registration part. Now we will be moving towards our other activity, that is add course activity, in which we will be adding the new courses. So inside this add course activity, firstly here we will change the parent layout to scroll view. And inside the scroll view, we will be firstly adding the background. Then we will be adding a relative layout, specifying width as match parent, height as wrap content. Inside this, we will be using a linear layout, specifying width as match parent, height wrap content, orientation as vertical. Inside this screen linear layout, we will be creating multiple text input field. So we will copy one from here and we will be using the same multiple times. Here only the difference will be we have to change it to simple text and we have to remove the margin as well. Here firstly we will change the ID, or we can remove the ID. We will be not using the ID for text input layout. Only the ID which we will be requiring is this one. So the first one will be for our course name, ID ADT course name. So we will now copy this read text and use it multiple times. After adding course name, we have to add course price, then our best suited for, then course image link and course link. So these are the different fields. So this one is for, here we will be adding margin top as 20 dp. Here also we will change margin start and margin 10 a little bit, that is 10. We'll remove others and use them again. This will be for our course price. Now we will copy this edit text and use it multiple times. And inside the course price, the input type will be number. So here we have added different field. So the third field will be for our enter course suited for. Then the next field will be for course image link. The next field will be for course link. Now after adding course link, we have to add the course description. So we will be using the similar one, but here we will be specifying the constant height. So we will be copying this one. We will change the height to 200 dp. Change height here as match parent. Course course description. And after that we have to create a button for adding a course. Specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, margin start as 10 dp, margin end also as 10 dp, margin top as 20 dp, text as add course, all caps as false, then background as custom button back, margin bottom also as 10 dp, id now after that we have to add the progress bar. So we will go out of our linear layout, and inside which we will be adding the progress bar. Specify width as wrap content, height as wrap content, we will be adding it, layout center in parent as true, indeterminate drawable, progress back indeterminate as true, we will be initially making its visibility as gone. Now we have created the UI for our activity underscore add course. Now we will be initializing all these variables which we have created inside our add course activity.java file. So we will be closing our login activity here and registration as well. Now inside this activity, firstly we will be creating variable for our text input edit text. So the first one will be for course name edit text, then course price edit text, course suited for edit text, after that we will be creating a variable for a button. Along with that we will be creating two other variables, that is for our Firebase database. Firebase database and then database reference. And we will be creating a string. We will be creating it later. Now we have to initialize this all the variables. So firstly, course name. Then we will be initializing others, that is price suited for, image, link, description. So we will change the ID and variable name here. Now we will be also initializing our Firebase database and getting its instance, firebase database.get instance. After that, we will be initializing database reference as Firebase database dot get reference, and inside this we will be passing our reference as courses. Now after that, we will be adding onclick listener for our add course button, and we will be adding set onclick listener new view dot onclick listener. Now we will be getting the data from our edit text, and for that we will be firstly creating a string as course name, similarly we will be creating it for others, that is price, best suited for image, link, description. So we will be changing this one, that is course price. Then suited for, then comes the next as a course image, course link. Course description edit text. Now after getting all this data, we also have to specify the ID. So for that we will be creating a variable, course ID, and we will be initializing this course ID with our course name. So the ID will be initialized for the first time. I will be also, when we will be creating a database, when the data has been added to the our Firebase database, then I will be displaying this course ID as well there. Now we have get all this data from our edit text. So now we have to add this data to our Firebase database. So for that we have to create a model class inside which we will be adding all these variables, and we will be passing the variable for that model class inside our Firebase database. So for that we have to create a model. For that we have to go to package name, right click new, Java class, and course RV model. So this will be the similar model class for our recycler view, as well as we will be using the same for adding the data. Now inside this we will be creating a different variables. So the first one variable will be our course name, the second one will be for our course price and others as well. So we will create this. Course description, then course price, best suited for, course image, course link, and the next one will be our course ID. Now after that we have to firstly create an empty constructor. So the empty constructor is required when we are using the Firebase for performing the CRUD operations. Without empty constructor you might face some issues. Firebase empty constructor is required when we are using Firebase. So we will be creating an empty constructor. So this one will be our empty constructor. Now after that we have to create getter and setter methods. So for that we simply have to right click, then generate. Firstly we will be generating our constructor, and inside constructor we will be selecting all the variables, and we will be creating our constructor. Now our constructor has been created. Similarly we have to create getter and setter method. So for that we have to go to generate, getter and setter, select all the variables, and we will be creating the getter and setter method for all. Now after that we have to implement this model class using the parselable implementation, as we will be passing the data from one activity to another activity, and for that we will be using the parselable. So for that we will have to simply add parselable, and then we have to simply click on this red bulb and implement methods. So it will implement the method, that is firstly the write to parcel method has been implemented. Now here we can again get to see a error, then we have to right click add parselable implementation. So it will automatically add the parselable implementation inside our model class. Now the parcelable has also been implemented, and here we can also get to see the creator for it as well. Now we have to again go to our add course activity, and inside this we will be passing all these variables to our model class which we have recently created. So for that, course RV model equal to new course RV model, and inside this firstly we will be passing our course ID, then we will be passing our course name, then course description, then course price, best suited for. So firstly we have passed our course name, course ID will be at last, so we will be removing the course ID from here. So first one is the course name, then course description, then course price, best suited for. After that we have to pass course image, then course link, and then after that we have to pass course ID. Now after that we will be adding this model to our database. So for that firstly we have to call database reference dot add value event listener, new value event listener. Now the two methods has been created, that is on data change and on cancel. So inside on data change method we have to set this data. So for that we have to simply call database reference dot child. We will be setting the ID as course ID which we are being generated, that is will be the course name. Then we will have to simply call set value method, and inside this we have to pass the model class which we have created. So this will add all the data for the specific course inside our database. Now after that we will simply display a toast message as course added, and we will be opening our activity, that is main activity. So we will be not requiring this method, so I will remove this. Inside on cancel method we will be displaying the error which we got while adding the data. Now we have completed the add course screen. We have also added the UI as well as completed the add course activity. Now we have to start working on the edit course activity. So the UI for add as well as edit course activity will be same. So we will simply copy the UI. The only difference is there are two buttons instead of one. So we will completely copy this relative layout. Inside our edit course activity, we will go to edit course activity. Then we will change the constraint to scroll view. Here also we will add background as blue shade one, and then we will be adding this relative layout here as well. So all will be the same, only the difference will be is that we have to simply change this button. So for that we will be adding a linear layout here, specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, margin start as 10 dp, margin end as 10 dp, margin top as 20 dp, we will be adding weight sum as 2, orientation as horizontal, and inside this we will be creating a button. So we will copy this and use it here, specify width as 0 dp, weight as 1. We will be removing this margin and we will add a simple margin to it, that is around 8 dp. The first button will be for our update course. Here I will change the ID, update course. Then I will create a similar button. This one will be for our delete operation. Delete course. Now we have created the two buttons for our updating as well as deleting our course. We will be also adding text color as white. Now we will start working on our activity, that is main activity.java file. So we have completed the login, registration, adding a new course as well as updating and deleting the course. We have created the UI. We will be moving towards firstly edit course activity. Inside this we will be copying the data from here because all the variables are similar, so we will be simply copying it from here. Instead of one button we will be displaying the two buttons. So the two buttons will be, the first one will be the update course button and the next one will be delete course button. Along with that we will be also copy their IDs along with their initialization because the IDs are similar. We will only change the button, that is first one is the update course, then the next one is our delete course, delete course button. So after that we will be adding onclick listener for all this. Along with that we will be creating a variable for our course RV model, that is course RV model. We also have to initialize our Firebase, that is Firebase database dot get instance, database reference equal to Firebase database dot get reference, and inside this we have to pass the reference. That is our courses. Make sure the reference which we have added inside the add courses activity, that is courses, will be similar. Along with that, inside our edit course activity we have also have to specify the child, and the child will be our course ID. So we will be specifying this line below because we have not get the data from our previous activity. So edit and update course activity will be open when we open an new course, that is when we click on the existing course and we simply click on the edit course, then after we are opening it. So for that firstly we will have to get the data from our previous activity. Now for getting the data from previous activity we will be simply using course RV model equal to get intent dot get parcelable extra. And here we will be passing it with the help of the course key. Now here we will check whether the course RV model is not equal to null. If it is not equal to null, then we will be setting all the data which we got from our previous activity to all our edit text. So we will simply call course name edit text dot set text course RV model dot get course name. Similarly we will be setting for price, suited for, image, link, description. Course price, get course price, course suited for, get best suited for, course image, course link, then our course description. So we have set the data to our edit text, as well as we have to create one more variable, that is course ID. So we'll be calling course ID equal to course RV model dot get course ID. Now after that we have initialized our database reference, because here we are passing our course ID and we are getting the course ID previously. So after passing the course ID to our database reference, we have to add onclick listener for our, that is, update button. Inside this we will be simply calling loading progress bar dot set visibility as visible, and inside our add course activity as well, here we have not specified the loading progress bar dot set visibility as visible, and inside the on data change, loading progress bar dot set visibility as gone. Now we will again move to our edit course. Inside the update button, firstly we will get the data from our edit text. So the, that is, first one will be our course name edit text dot get text dot toString. So this is the similar procedure we have already done it here, that is getting all the data from our edit text. So we will copy all these fields and use the similar one here. That is getting all the data from our edit text. Now after that we will be creating a model, that is update course RV model. Or now here we will be creating a map instead of model, because we have used the model here. Now I will also tell you the another approach for passing the data to our database, that is by using the hash map or a map. So for that we will be simply creating a map. Then inside this we will be passing a string and an object. We will be creating a new hash map. We will be importing this one. Now inside this map we have to put our data with the help of a key and value pair. So the first will be our course name. Make sure that the key name will be similar to that of our course RV model. So this is our first key, and inside our edit we have to use it here. So I will firstly add all the variables. So the first one will be the course name, then course description, then course price. After that the next one will be for best suited for or suited for course image, course link. Now we have to change the keys, that is, next one will be for course description, then course price, then best suited for. The next key is for our course image. So we will check the key as well, that is, all are correct or not. Then our course link at last. Here we will be not updating our course ID, because the ID will be unique for each course. So we will be keeping the ID as it is. And we will be adding the same ID once again. So we will be calling the course ID. Here for course ID we are not getting the data from edit text, or we are not initializing it, so we will be getting it from the course ID which we have already initialized here, that is from the previous screen we are getting the data. Now after that we have to again call our database reference dot add value event listener, new value event listener. Inside this we have to simply call loading progress bar dot set visibility is gone. Database reference dot set value Instead of set, we have to call update children, and here we have to pass the map which we have created as map. Now after that, we have to display a toast message as course updated, and we have to start a new activity. That is our main activity. Inside on cancel, we will be displaying a toast message as failed to update course. Now we have completed the update part, so I will minimize this one. Now after update, we will be adding on click listener for our delete course button. Set on click listener, new. Now inside this delete course, we will be creating a separate method for deleting it. Private void delete course, and inside this we will be simply calling database reference dot remove value. So the ID is already given here, so we will be simply calling database dot remove value. It will remove the complete value for that specific reference. After that, we have to display a toast message, course deleted, and again we have to start our activity, that is main activity. Now we will be calling this method here, that is delete course. So we will be calling the delete course method here. Now we have completed the coding part for edit course as well. We have completed, till now we have completed login, registration, adding a course, editing as well as deleting a course. Now after that, we have to go to our main activity for reading all the data from our database. Now inside our main activity for reading the data, firstly we will be displaying it in the form of a recycler view, so we will have to remove this text view. Then we will change the background as blue shade one. Here we will change the root one to relative. After that, we have to specify the recycler view, specify width as match parent, height also as match parent, ID as courses. Then after that, we will be creating a progress bar, specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content. Determinant as true, progress back, layout center in parent as true. Along with that, we have to also create a floating action button, specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content, align parent bottom as true, align parent end as true, background tint as blue shade 2. We will be adding a margin little bit as 20 dp. Now we will be adding the icon, so for that we have to go to drawable, vector assets. Now we'll select this add icon. We will change the icon into add. Now after that, we have to initialize these variables So for that we have to go to our main activity.java file and firstly create a variable for our recycler view. That is our course RV. Then for our progress bar, then for our floating action button. After that we have to create for our Firebase database. Similarly for our database reference. Now we have to initialize these variables. Along with that we have to create a variable for our array list. That is course RV model. Along with that we have to also create variable for our adapter, which we will be creating, and one more we will be required, that is for relative layout we have to specify a ID which we will be using for displaying our bottom sheet. So we will be creating variable for that as well. Now firstly we will be creating our adapter class for our recycler view, as well as we will be requiring a layout file. So we will be moving firstly for layout file, then adapter, and then we will create a variable for it. Now inside the layout folder we have to right click new layout resource file, then this one is a course RV item. We have to change root layout to card view and create our course RV item. Now firstly we will be changing the height as wrap content, then gravity as center, margin as 5 dp, card corner radius as 4 dp, card elevation as around 3 dp. Now inside this we will be creating a relative layout, specifying width as match parent, height as wrap content. We will be adding background as blue shade 1. Now inside this relative layout we will be firstly adding an image view which will be used for displaying the course image. Specify width as match parent, height as 200 dp, id as idiv course. Then we will be adding scale as center crop. Now inside this, after this creating this image view, we will be creating a text view which will be used for displaying our course name. Specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, text as our course name, text color as white, text style as bold. We will be aligning below to our course IV. Then we will be adding margin as 3 dp, padding as 4 dp, text size as 15 sp. After that we have to create one more text view for displaying the course price. Specify width as wrap content, height also as wrap content, text as price, text size around 15 sp, padding 4 dp, margin 3 dp, below idiv course, line parent end to true, id as idtv price. Here we have to add text color as white, text style as bold. Here we have to add ID. IDTV course name, then price. We will be aligning this course name to left of our price TV so that it will not be overlapped with each other. we will be adding single line as true, and for text price text view as well, we will be adding single line as true. Now we have created the UI for our each item of our recycler view. We will be initializing this layout file inside our adapter class. So for creating adapter, we have to go to package name, right click new Java class. We have to create course RV adapter. Extends with recycler view dot adapter. Now we have to implement these methods. After implementing this method, we have to create inner class for our view holder, that is for our view holder we have to create an inner class. We have to make it to public and extends recycler view dot view holder. Now inside this class, firstly we will have to inflate our layout file, as well as we will be adding the animation to a recycler view as well. So firstly we will be creating variables, that is array list, core survey model, then we will be creating a last position indexed as -1. After that, for on click for our course, we will be creating an interface. So for creating interface, we have to write public interface. Course click interface, and inside this, we have to create method as void on course click, and inside this we have to pass the position. Now we have to create variable for this course click interface as well. And after that we have to create constructor. We have to not consider the last position. Other than that, we have to add the three variables, that is context, ArrayList, and course click interface. Now after that, inside our onCreateViewHolder method, we have to inflate the layout file which we have created. So for that, view layoutInflator dot from context dot inflate the layout file which we have created, course RV item, comma parent dot false, and then we simply have to return new view holder, and inside this we have to pass the view. Now after that we have to go to our onBind view holder method, and we will be setting the data. Firstly we have to initialize all the variables. So for that, firstly we will be creating variables for our text view, that is course name TV, then course price TV. After that we will be creating a variable for our image view. Course IV. Now we will be initializing them with their IDs. Item view dot find view by ID. Course price TV. Item view. Item view Now we have initialized all the variables with their IDs. After that, inside get item count, we have to return the size of our array list dot size. Now we will be going towards onBind view holder for setting the data. Firstly, we will be getting the data from our array list inside our model class. Dot get position. Now after that, we have to set data, that is holder dot course name tv dot set text course rv model dot get course name. Similarly for course price, dot get price. So we will be concatenating the string here. Then we will be using Picasso dot get dot load, and inside this we will be loading our image URL dot get course image dot into folder dot course IV. After that we have to add on click listener for our item view, and we have to call interface inside this, that is course click interface dot on course click, and inside this we have to pass the position. Now we have completed the coding part for our adapter class. One more thing which we have left is we have to add the animation for our each item of our recycler view. So inside onBind view holder method, before the onClick we will be adding the animation, that is we will be creating a separate method for adding an animation. So we will be calling it as a private void set animation, and inside this we will be passing the our item view and the position. So here we will be calling this method, that is set animation. Inside this we will be passing our item view, which will be our folder dot item view comma position. Inside the set animation method we will firstly check if position is greater than last position, and then we will be calling creating a animation. Animation utils dot load animation. We will be adding the slide in left animation for displaying animation, adding the item from left to right. Set animation, that is animation. And we will be updating last position to position. Now we have also added animation to our each item of our recycler view. Now the adapter class is fully complete. Now we will be creating variable for adapter inside our main activity as well. So for that we have to create variable course rv adapter, then course rv adapter. Now after that we have to initialize all our variables. So firstly our course rv, then our loading progress bar, then our add fab, we have not given id for our floating action button. So we will be using it here. Then for our Firebase database, that is getting the instance of Firebase database. Similarly for our database reference, get reference, inside which we will be passing the courses. Make sure that the key value should be similar in everyone. This is the key from which we will be getting all our data. Then course rv model array list, then after home rl, or we will be here we will be adding the bottom sheet. So we will be changing, that is IDS bottom sheet RL, and we will be initializing it later after we have created our bottom sheet layout. Then course RV adapter. Inside this, we will be passing firstly our list, that is course model array list, then our context, and then our onclick interface, as we have not implemented it. So we have to implement this, implements course RV adapter dot course click interface. So we have to implement this methods, that is on course click interface. Now after that, we have to firstly set the layout manager for our recycler view, that is course RV dot set layout manager, new linear layout manager. As we are displaying it in a vertical, so we will be setting layout manager as vertical. We will be displaying the list in the vertical manner, so we are only displaying linear layout manager, and this it will be set in a vertical manner. Now after that, we have to add adapter. So for adding adapter, that is course RV dot set adapter course RV adapter. After that, we have to add on click listener for our add fab dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener. Now inside on fab, we have to simply start a new activity, start activity, that is open our add course activity, main activity dot this comma add course activity dot class. So this will be opening a new activity, that is add course activity. Now after that, we will be creating a method for getting all the courses. So we will be creating the different method for here, private void get all courses. This will be used to read all the courses, and we will be calling this method here, that is get all courses. Now inside this method, we will be reading all the courses from our database. So firstly, we will be calling our list dot clear, and then we will be calling our database reference dot add child event listener, new child event listener. This will be used to read all the data from our database. Now firstly, inside the on child method, this will be called when the new child has been added. So we will be firstly calling the loading progress bar, changing the visibility of our loading progress bar dot set visibility as gone. Here we will not be requiring this, so I will remove. Now after that, we have to call course RV model arrays dot add snapshot dot get value. And we will be getting the value in the form of course RV model, course RV model dot class. After that, we have to notify our adapter that data inside our list has been changed. So we will be calling course RV adapter dot notify data set change. Now inside on child change method, we only have to do the similar procedure, that is loading progress bar dot set visibility as gone. And then we have to simply notify our adapter that data has been changed or updated. Similarly, on child removed as well, we will be using the same code. This will be called when the child has been removed, and inside the moved as well, when child position has been moved. And in on cancel method, we have to not do anything. Now the reading part has also been done, so we will be reading all the courses from this get all courses method by using the database reference, and there are different methods inside this as well. Now after that, we have to add on course click, that is we have to add on click listener when each course inside our recycler view has been clicked. So this is the method for the on course click. And inside this, we will have to display a bottom sheet. So for this, we have to firstly create a bottom sheet layout. For that, we have to go to layout, then right click new layout resource file, then bottom sheet dialog, we have to change it to relative layout and create a bottom sheet dialog. Now inside this we will change the height to wrap content, specify background as blue shade 1. Inside this, firstly we will be creating our, that is text view for our course name. So we will be creating a simple text view. Specify width as match parent, height as wrap content, text as course name, text color as white, text style as bold, ID as course name, margin as 4 dp, padding also as 4 dp, text size as 15 sp, text style we have already added as bold. Now after this text view we have to create an image view for displaying our course image. Specify width and height as constant, which will be around 100. dp. We will align this below to our IDTV course name. We will be adding margin as 4 dp. Currently we will be adding source as our launcher icon. Then we will be adding padding as 4 dp. Center vertical as true. After this image view, we will have to create a other text views, that is first text view. Specify width as match parent, height wrap content, text. This will be for a description. So we will be adding ID as text color as white, text style will be normal, so we will be not adding it. We will be adding write of IDIV course, then below to our IDTV course name, text color we have already added. Then we have to specify the text size, which will be similar. Padding as 3 dp, margin as 4 dp. Now similarly we have to create other text view that is suited for end price. So in price we have to add text size as 18 sp, then text style will be bold. We'll have to change the ID as IDTV price. We will align it below to our, that is description. Then after that we will be aligning this course price below to our suited for. Now after that we have to add two buttons. For that we will be creating a linear layout, specifying width as match parent, height as wrap content. We will be adding orientation as horizontal, then weight sum as 2. We will be running below to our course image view. Inside this linear layout we will be creating buttons. Specify width as 0 dp, height as wrap content, weight as 1, margin as 4 dp, text as edit course, all caps as false, text color as white, ID. We will be creating a similar button for our view details. Now we have created the layout file for our bottom sheet. Here in the relative layout, we have to specify the ID. Bottom sheet. Now we have to use this bottom sheet layout file inside our main activity.java. So here we have created bottom sheet RL. Now we will initialize this with the ID. Here we have specified the ID for our bottom sheet. We have to use this ID. Now after clicking on course click, we have to display our bottom sheet. So for that we will be creating a different method for displaying our bottom sheet, that is private void display bottom sheet, and inside this we will be passing our item, that is course rv model, and we will be calling this display bottom sheet method inside the on course click, and we will be getting course model release.get and position. Now inside the display bottom sheet method, we will be firstly creating a bottom sheet dialog, that is bottom sheet dialog. Then we will be simply creating a layout file, that is view, and inflating our layout file which we have created, layout inflator dot from context. The context will be over this dot inflate bottom sheet dialog, and inside this we will be passing the relative layout, that is bottom sheet RL. Now after that we will be simply calling bottom sheet dialog dot set content view, and inside this we will be passing our layout as a content view. After that we will be calling bottom sheet dialog dot set cancelable as false. Bottom sheet dialog dot set cancel on touch outside as true. After that we will be simply displaying our bottom sheet dialog as true. Now after that we will be creating variables for our different views. So first one will be the text view, as course name TV equal to layout dot find view by id TV course name. Similarly for course description, best suited for price and image view. So second will be for course description, that is ID to description, then course suited for TV, suited for. After that we have to call course price, course price. Then for our image view, that is course IV. Now after creating these variables, we have to set the data for our course name, description and all. So for that we will simply call course name tv.setText, course rv model dot get course name. Similarly for description, suited for price, that is course description. Then our suited for, then our course price TV. So for description we will be calling get course description, then get suited for, that is get best suited for. Similarly for get price, for price we will be adding as rupees. After that, for setting image we will be calling picasso.get load core survey model dot get course image dot into course IV. After that we will be creating the variables for our button as well, that are there are two buttons. So one button for edit button, and the next one is for view details button. Button edit, that is view details, and after that we will be adding on click listener for both the buttons. Edit details button, that is dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener. Similarly for our view details button, dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener. Now inside edit details button we will be calling intent main activity dot this comma edit course activity dot class. Now here we have to pass the data to our next activity, so for that we will be simply here we will be calling I, but before that we have to pass the data, that is I dot put extra, and inside this we will be passing the key and then our course RV model. So make sure that this one key and the key which we have used in edit course activity will be the same, so that we can get the data in the next activity, otherwise it may provide some error. Now after that, inside the view details button we have to simply call the intent I equal to new intent intent dot action view I dot set data URI dot parse, and inside this we have to pass our URL, that is course RV model dot course link, and we have to simply call start activity and pass the intent. Now this is the code for our display bottom sheet. We have completed the bottom sheet part as well, and we have also completed the get courses part. Now we have to move towards the next part, that is for logout of a user. So for that we have to create a menu resource file for displaying a top navigation menu. For that we have to simply go to our dress folder, then right click new, then we have to go to Android resource directory. Here we have to select menu, directory name as menu, and then simply click on OK. So the new directory for menu will be created. Then after that we have to create a new file, then new. Here we have to specify menu underscore main as a file name, then simply click on OK to create a new file. Now inside this file we have to create the first item. The one item will be first item will be for our logout. We'll be specifying ID as ID logout. Then we will be adding title as logout. Now we will be using this layout file inside our main activity. So inside main activity, for inflating this layout file there are two methods, on create option menu and on option item selected. So firstly we will be calling on create option menu, that is this method. So this method will be called when the options menu has been created. So we will remove this. When the option menu has been called, then we have to simply inflate a layout, that is get menu inflator dot inflate r dot menu dot menu main. After that we have to simply return true. Then after that we have to call on option item selected method. This will be called when the any of the option from this option item has been inflated. So for that, firstly we will be creating an integer that is id, and we will be getting the item dot get item id. So in this we will be getting the id for item which on which the user clicks. So we will be calling switch id. Inside this, the first case will be for r dot id dot logout, that is logout. And in the case of logout, firstly we will be displaying a toast message, user logged out, and after that we have to open a new script, that is call mauth. So here we have to create variable for auth as well. Firebase auth and mauth, and we have to initialize this mauth equal to firebase auth dot get instance. Now inside, after displaying this toast message, we have to simply call mauth.signout. So this method will be called for signing out the user, and after that we will simply call intent I equal to new intent and start our login activity once again. Start activity I, and we will be finishing our this activity. Now we will run our application once again to see the output of our application. So now we have completed the coding part. These are the different activities which we have completed. So the first one will be the registration activity which we have completed. Inside this activity, user will be registered first time. Then comes the login activity which is used for logging the user inside our application. Then is the add course activity for adding a new course. Then our edit course activity for updating as well as deleting our existing course. Then comes our main activity for displaying the list of courses which are all present inside our database. Now we will run our application to see the output of our application. Now our application has been installed. We will take a look at the output of our application. So here we can get to see our application. Firstly, we can get to see the login screen. Then after clicking on this button, we can get to see a register screen. We will align this a little bit above. So currently we will register our screen, but before that I will also show you the Firebase database inside which we will be storing our all the courses and as well as users. So here is our Firebase database. Currently the database is empty, and firstly we will be registering our user. So I will go to authentication tab. Here we can get to see a new user which we will be creating now. So I will be creating a user, then specify a password. Then simply click on the register. So our new user has been created, and we are coming to them. That is our main activity. Currently there is no data has been added, so it will show a loading dialog. Now we will refresh the screen. I will go to sign in method and come in again to user. So here we can get to see one user has been added. Similarly, if the multiple users register, then we can get to see their credentials. That is only the username here. So now our username has been created. Now we will add course. So when we will add course, we have to go to real-time database. So the course which we will be adding will be displayed here inside this. So we will be adding the course, but firstly we will copy the image link. So the course will be for our Microsoft test series. We will simply click on floating action button. Price will be 0. Beginners. Then course image link will be we just copied. Then the course link will be this one. So we will be using this course link. After that we will be using the course description, which is present here. So here we have to simply add the multiple line, that is we have to go to our edit as well as add, and inside the layout file we will add the changes, so that when we run it to the next time it will be proper. So inside the description here we have to add single line as false. Input type will be, that is text multiline, text IME multiline. So this will be used for adding the input type to multiple line. Similarly for our add course as well, we will be changing it, that is inside add course activity as well. So inside the course description edit text, we will be adding input, changing input type to this one. So next time when we will run it again, it will be proper. Now we have to simply click on add course. Again, I will go to database before clicking it. So here is our database. Now I will simply click on add course. So we can get to see the course has been added. So this is our first course which has been added. Here we can get to see the first is our course ID, that is Microsoft Test Series. Then best suited for description, course ID, course image, course link, name and price. So in this way we can add the data. Now I will add again one more course. So this is the complete interview preparation. I will simply click on this floating action button. Course price is 6999. Then best suited for beginners. I am keeping it as a beginners for the test purpose. Then course image link, we will be using this image. So I will simply click on open image in a new tab. And this one is this course image. I will copy this and use it here. Select all, then paste. Similarly, I will be copying this, or I will simply copy this course link for each type so that all the course will be visible. Select all, then paste. And currently I am adding the description as complete interview preparation. So we will simply add the course, and we can get to see the course has been added in the database as well. So in this way we can add this courses. So here also we can get to see the course has been added. Now to view this course, we have to simply click on this, and then we can view the details of this course. So the new intent has been opened, and this page, the URL which we provided, so this URL has been opened inside our web page. Now we can get to see the similar page here as well, that is online courses. So now we have tested the registration feature as well as course addition. Now we will update this course. Also we have to change the UI as well of this bottom sheet. So we will go to our bottom sheet, that is bottom sheet dialog, and we will align this linear layout to below of our price, so that it will not overlap, that is below to our price TV. Now it's proper. Now we will run application once again. So firstly, we will go to our edit course. Then we will edit the course price to 499. And we will simply click on update course. Now here we can get to see our course price has been updated to 499 as we have not run the application once again. So the UI is similar. So the course price is updated. So we have seen the adding the database, reading the database that is displaying the data in the form of list is reading. Then user authentication with a login and registration. We have seen the registration, not a login. Now we will move towards the deleting part. So I will click on this course, then edit this course. Then I will simply go down and click on delete. So this course will be deleted and the only one course will be left. Now this is all about the performing the CRUD operations. Now I will log out. Also in the database, we can get to see that course has been deleted and the only one course is being left. Now I will log out of this. So I will simply click on these three dots and then simply click on log out. So the user is now log out of the application, log out of the application. Now I will log in again with the same credentials, that is the credentials for that account is abc@gmail.com. And we have added password and again login. We can get to see the login successful message here so that the user has been logged in. Now I will create one more user and log in with that. So I will simply click on create a new user e@gmail.com, then password as 123456, then similar password, and then again click on register. So the user will be registered and we can get to see the list of the courses as well. It is taking a little bit time for registering due to some poor connection. We also have to update this register button, that is layout. So here we can get to see user has been registered. Now we will refresh it again so that we can get to see the list of users here. That is the recent one along with the date. Now we will also update the registration activity, that is we will change the margin top of this already a new user. We will decrease it little bit to 20 dp. Now we will run our application once again to see the all the updated changes. Now I have run our application once again, so we can get to see, now I will click on this, so we can get to see the buttons are been properly aligned inside our bottom sheet. So if you are having any doubts regarding what you are explained in this video, do ask in the comment sections. For complete code, refer the articles present in the description box below. So do like this video, subscribe to this channel, and thanks for watching.